Hey guys, I've got the Ghost 212 Predator in hand here, and I went ahead and made a disassembly. I've got the video, but I'm still working on that. But I want to go through some of the high and low points with you. Here's the block. Now this block is just a undrilled stock block. There's no reinforcement, no back rib on the back there, cylinder. Now this is the DUCAR 212 Hemi block. Of course, it's got a good reinforced back rib there on the lower cylinder, and it's a pretty good reinforced block. So, the Ghost is not a DUCAR. And the camshaft from the Ghost, it's got some numbers on it, but honestly, it doesn't look anything other than stock. Now, I've not put a degree wheel on it or anything, but I'm not impressed. The camshaft size is about 549,000, so it's clone cam size. And that figures because I think what we got here, this is the 212 Hemi that I bought to pull the head and do the Hemi 224. And if you'll notice, we have an exact match. So what the Ghost is a 212 Hemi engine, which is, I think it's manufactured by Loncin, with this DUCAR Hemi head. Now, the valves are just look like regular DUCAR valves. There's nothing spectacular. You got a 27 millimeter intake and a 24 millimeter exhaust. They are both dished. Now this is the head off of the 212 DUCAR right here. Got those longer studs sticking out. And, I don't know. There's maybe, I don't know if there's the same numbers or a little different. I think maybe the exhaust valve on the Predator Ghost does have a different part number on it, but it looks identical. And, of course, the rod and piston from the Ghost. It looks like a DUCAR dished piston with the big valve relief cut in it. The big rod deal about the squeeze cast and all that, it's just a cast rod. See, they've got LY on the castings. One's out of the DUCAR and the other one's out of the one in my right hand's out of the Predator 212 Ghost. And here's your cast iron flywheel that comes on the Ghost. Just a screwed and glued cheapie. And by contrast, the DUCAR 212 Hemi comes with this nice PVL aluminum, which it's not billet, but it is rated till 17,000 RPM. Your crankshafts. This one does have, it says cam or something on it. That's out of the Ghost. And it is... I'll measure it here in a minute, but it is clone size, so it's 1 inch, 179 thousandths. Here's the crankshaft out of the DUCAR. They're virtually identical. Yeah, I'll go ahead and put a mic on it. 1 inch, 179 thousandths, and switch it over. Yep. It's pretty close. It's not too bad out around. It might be just a little out around, but not bad. I've seen worse. You probably have too. So what they did, they took a Hemi block, stock Loncin Hemi block, and they did not drill the holes for the governors. And so that's our block we've got with this Ghost. And here's the Rev Limiting Coil that comes on the Ghost. It's a lot thicker than the DUCAR Hemi coil are on the bottom. Now the DUCAR 212 Hemi that I purchased from EC, it is not a rev limiting coil, and I'll have to purchase another coil because that rev limiting coil is probably going in the trash. Well, I won't say that's spare tiller parts. And here's the big PZ22 $20 carburetor. It says Japan on it, but yeah. a lot of the Chinese Makunis say Japan too, but they're not. The side cover. Yeah, you do get this top oil fill there, but it is just a cast side cover, bearing side cover. Nothing spectacular. Matter of fact, it's almost identical to the one on the little LCT 4995 engine. However, you do get this nice sheet metal top plate. That's probably, you know, $20 maybe. So, all in all, I gotta say, I was not impressed. For $300, don't waste your money, guys. That's all I got. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.